Hi, this is Dr. A. In this medical terminology video, we're going to go over the pathologies that are related to your respiratory system. So we're going to start with the upper respiratory system, and so that's like from the larynx up, right? And so anything that kind of affects you up here. Croup is an acute respiratory condition in children. It is characterized by a barking type of cough. Diphtheria is a bacterial infection that is characterized by the formation of a thick membrane film across the throat and a high mortality rate. Some of those, so diphtheria and pertussis and even croup, are covered by vaccination. So, laryngitis is an inflammation of the larynx. Nasopharyngitis is an inflammation of the nose and pharynx, so nose and throat, usually called the common cold. Pertussis is a bacterial infection of the upper respiratory system characterized by a whooping cough. And so that's its other name, it's whooping cough. Pharyngitis is an inflammation of the pharynx, commonly called a sore throat. And rhinomycosis is a fungal infection of the nasal cavity. So now we're going to go down to the bronchial tube. Pathologies that just affect the bronchial tubes. So asthma is a difficulty breathing that is caused by bronchospasms, dyspnea, so difficulty breathing, coughing, and wheezing. Bronchiectasis is an enlarged bronchi that is often due to infection and can cause destruction of the bronchial wall. Bronchitis is an inflammation of a bronchus, and bronchogenic carcinoma is a cancerous tumor originating in the bronchi. So now we're going to move on to all the pathologies that affect the lungs. So adult respiratory distress syndrome, also abbreviated as ARDS, is acute respiratory failure in an adult. It is characterized by tachypnea, so fast breathing, dyspnea, difficulty breathing, cyanosis, so blowing of the lips and fingertips, and hypoxemia, or low oxygen level in the blood. Anthracosis is a type of pneumoconiosis. So conio, if you remember, is dust, and pneumo is lungs, and anthraco is coal dust. So it's, you know, a specific form of coniosis. And so it's a collection of coal dust in the lungs. It is also called black lung or coal miner's lungs. Asbestosis is another type of pneumoconiosis, but it's a collection of asbestos fibers in the lungs, and those can also lead to cancers. Atelectasis is a condition in which the alveoli in a portion of the lungs collapse. That prevents gas exchange in the lung. And incomplete dilation, the little alveoli, if they collapse flat, they kind of, once they collapse, they can't reinflate back. So that's the problem there. And it could lead to a collapsed lung. Chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, also known as COPD, is a progressive, chronic, and usually irreversible group of conditions. So there are many in there. There's chronic bronchitis and emphysema and others that are lumped under COPD. The lungs have a decreased capacity to function in COPD, and there's impaired gas exchange with retention of a lot of carbon dioxide. Cystic fibrosis, also abbreviated as CF, is a genetic condition. It produces very thick mucus that causes a severe congestion in the lungs and in the digestive tract. So part of the genetic mutation of cystic fibrosis is their mucus is not liquid enough, and so it gets really thick and sticky. Emphysema is a COPD, so it's a chronic lung condition that's characterized by the destruction of the alveolar walls. And so the alveoli, instead of having these nice like little bubble type shape, they get more dilated and they lose the roundness and lose surface area. Histoplasmosis is a fungal infection of the lungs. Infant respiratory distress syndrome is IRDS and is most common in premature infants, is characterized by tachypnea, so fast breathing, and respiratory grunting, so they're making an effort while they're breathing, so that's where the grunting comes in. And sometimes it is called hyaline membrane disease. Influenza, also known as flu, is a viral infection of the respiratory system. Legionnaire's disease is a severe bacterial infection that causes pneumonia and liver and kidney damage. Middle East Respiratory Syndrome, or MERS, is a life-threatening viral respiratory illness. The symptoms include fever, cough, and shortness of breath. And this is related to SARS-CoV-2 or COVID. Mycoplasma pneumonia is less severe but longer lasting form of bacterial pneumonia. It is also called walking pneumonia. Pneumoconiosis is accumulation of foreign particles such as coal dust in the lungs. So dust is conio. Pneumonia is an inflammatory condition of the lungs. It results in alveoli and air spaces filling with fluid. Pulmonary edema is an accumulation of an excessive amount of fluid in the lung tissues around the lungs, and that can cause one to almost like drown in their own fluids. Pulmonary embolism, or PE, is an obstruction of the pulmonary artery by a floating blood clot or an embolus, and that causes the infarct of the lung tissue. So wherever the embolus is stuck, anything below that is not able to get blood flow or oxygenation, and that can cause problems and death of the tissue, and collapse of the lung, and all kinds of things. Pulmonary fibrosis, formation of fibrous scar tissue in the lung. It leads to reduced ability to expand the lungs. Severe acute respiratory syndrome, or SARS, which again related to MERS, and now we have SARS-CoV-1, SARS-CoV-2, which we just went through with COVID. So this is an acute respiratory infection. It begins like the flu, but quickly progresses and has a very high mortality rate in people over 65. Silicosis is a type of pneumoconiosis, but it's the accumulation of silica dust in the lungs. Sleep apnea is when breathing stops repeatedly during sleep. It causes a drop in the oxygen levels. Sudden infant death syndrome, or SIDS, is an unexpected and unexplained death of an apparently well infant. The child stops breathing for unknown reasons. Tuberculosis, or TB, is a bacterial lung infection. It results in inflammation and calcification of the lungs. The incidence is on the rise, and the condition is common in immunocompromised patients. And lastly, we're going to look at pleural cavity pathology. Sorry, we have empyema. Empyema is an accumulation of pus in the pleural space, also called pyothorax. A pleural effusion is an accumulation of fluid in the pleural cavity, and the fluid accumulates and prevents the lungs from fully expanding, which then, of course, interferes with gas exchange. Pleurisy is an inflammation of the pleura. It is characterized by a sharp pain with each breath. And a pneumothorax is a collection of air in the pleural cavity, and it can result in a collapsed lung. And another one that's not listed here that's related to that is hemothorax, where the collection is, instead of air, is blood in the pleural cavity, but it has similar mechanisms where it can lead to a collapsed lung also. And so what happens here is with a pneumothorax is there's something that's punctured the chest wall cavity, and the air is getting here in that pleural space. And every time you take a breath in and out, there's more air that can enter the pleural space, and it causes the lungs to collapse. This can happen also if blood takes over fills up that space. So anyway, it's life-threatening. It's dangerous, and it's usually fixed by putting a chest tube in there and kind of helping exit that air and reinflate the lung. So anyway, that wraps it up for our pathologies of the respiratory system.